Today, my name is Enrique from here, Hunter College in New York, and today we are going to talk about dam removals and climate change. As you know very well, hydropower has been crucial in the history of this country, from the first industrial concentration in Lowell, for instance, to the demonstration of AC in Niagara. Or during the 20th century, for instance, you have the federal government building the massive hydroelectric projects like Hoover or Bonneville, etc. If you see here in the map, there was like a displacement, a geographical displacement from the east to the west in the 20th century. As you are going to see now in the next slide, something new is happening. And what is this new? Dam removals. I know what you are thinking, unthinkable. It is true, we are removing dams. But it is not something new. As you are going to see now in the next slide, this story started in the beginning of the 20th century, always, even during the Second World War. But since the 90s is when we have had the biggest concentration of dam removals. This is something unprecedented. It's really very important because we are removing many dams. This is a key example. The Edwards Dam, this is the first time in history that the federal government forced the owner to remove a dam because of environmental issues. The first time in history, 1999. This is another example in Oregon. The Marmot Dam removal, very small hydroelectric plant, approximately 20 megawatts. And you can see how all of these dams are concentrated, especially in the Pacific Northwest. The next one is going to be the Condit Dam, the second largest dam removal project in history. Again, approximately 20, 25 megawatts. And interestingly, this power is already replaced in the Pacific Northwest. No? The next example is the key example in history. It's the largest dam removal project in history that I participated in. This is what I know relatively well. The federal government removed two large dams in the Elwha River in the Pacific Northwest. And this is key for the future. Even if the San Clemente Dam is not a hydroelectric dam, but it is reflecting the current tendency that we are experiencing. This is the largest dam removal project in the history of California. This is going to be massive. Pay attention, please, in 2020, two dams, four dams, 170 megawatts. If this is happening, this is going to be open, perhaps, for the massive dams to be large. This is a very controversial project that I don't know if you know. It's the four dams in the lower Snake River. If that happens, this is going to be something incredible in our history. More than 1,000 megawatts of power there here in the Snake River. And these are the main causes why we are removing dams, mainly because they are old, or because of it is more expensive for the owner to repair or to maintain, or for river restoration, for instance, salmon, water quality, recreation. This is really part of my argument. Unprecedented weather conditions, as some of you say in this conference, connected to climate change. And how this is related to the dam infrastructure. This is going to be very important now. You remember this case. In February 2017, the tallest dam in the country, Oroville, was very close to collapse. 200,000 people had to be evacuated. Or more example, for instance, I apologize for the pronunciation, Guacatama Dam in Puerto Rico, you know, with the Hurricane Maria, almost collapsed, or in Houston, Texas, the fourth biggest city in the country. No? This is really a key question here. What is the significance of these extreme weather events associated to climate change in terms of dam removals and in terms of dam infrastructure? As you are going to see now, it's crucial. If you pay attention to all of these graphs, we have a very old dam infrastructure. By 2020, more than 80% of the dams are going to be old. And also, some states even don't have inspectors, like Alabama, for instance. There is another important example that can happen in the future, some of you from Arizona. Glen Canyon and the Hoover Dam. There are plans to combine everything in the Hoover Dam and to remove the Glen Canyon, to concentrate all the hydropower. And concluding this, my argument is, because of climate change, we are going to see more stress in the infrastructure dams. You are going to see more dam removals in the future. And unfortunately, our government is not paying incredible money for this. Thank you very much.